Well, if you don't take down this fence, I'll hop over it anyway. I've done some reading. Things don't have to be this way. You're worried I might climb the wall and stumble across your family tree. I bet you there's some roots down there you don't want me to see. Because your ancestors, they stole this land, sensed it off in a power grab and ripped it from beneath the feet of the folks who used to dwell on it. Drilled it into the consciousness for a couple of hundred years, and now it's so ingrained that no one even questions it. Who can go where? Who owns what? How much land have you got? Because we're craving birdsong and a lonely sunrise, an ancient tree and wildflowers in the summertime, swimming in the lake, sleeping beneath the stars. These simple things, they are inherently ours. But when one man owns 15,000 acres, well, that doesn't sound fair to the common folk of England. Class, money, power, and land ownership. Who gets to decide what's in the national interest? This is more than just a fence around the countryside. By fencing off the commons, they're fencing off our minds, and we're only given access to a smidgen of our rivers, and we're going stir crazy in the towns and the cities, knowing nature can fill that hole. We just need a ride to Rome. Oh, we just want to walk the land, treat it like common ground. We want to feel at home and welcome in nature. Stop saying that the country's full and hiding it behind a wall. Well, anyone who crosses gets labeled a trespasser. Who can go where? Who owns what? And how much land have you got? Because we're craving birdsong and a lonely sunrise, an ancient tree and wildflowers in the summertime, swimming in the lake, sleeping beneath the stars. These simple things, they are inherently ours. But when one man owns 50,000 acres, well, that doesn't sound fair to the common folk of England. So if you don't take down this fence, we'll hop over it anyway. We come in numbers, things don't have to be this way. Yeah!